My screen is visible to you. So today's topic and agenda is Spago self-contained ML and NLP library and deploying on Kubernetes. Our agenda of this today's session is audience, those who wanted to learn Dockerize Go application or any application. And good to have if you already know the Docker. There is a plus point. And those who want to learn around Go and machine learning and NLP libraries, so Spago is one of the library. Start my talk with why Docker and ML, or why we need data science engineer need to adopt this kind of DevOps tools like Docker. So a little bit about myself. My name is Sangam Biradar. I'm a Docker community leader, Bangalore, and I'm a cloud native developer. Mostly I work with Go and cloud native tools, and you can follow me on GitHub and you can check all the repo, and you can connect with me on Discord using discord.kubedaily.live. So before starting my talk, I want to explain something. Maybe you are a beginner, so here is my code, and let's say I have a development system that is Ubuntu, and maybe I'm for my machine learning things I'm using NVIDIA drivers or GPU CPU, or maybe you are running some kind of a deep learning models. For that you need a GPU, or maybe you are doing a small normal machine learning thing, so you need a good CPU. So we do this kind of prefer developing application on such kind of environment. And what the main thing is that when we train the model, maybe we train the model ourselves, or maybe we use a trained model already. So in that case, when you move to production, or when you build this kind of tools, managing a dependency is very breaking point. When you use this kind of thing, and let's say TensorFlow, if you are using TensorFlow 1.13 and suddenly new update came 1.14, maybe you will get some kind of errors, a particular model is not working or some kind of issue. So dependencies, maintaining dependencies always issue, and running on every and each environment as the same. So that's where a Docker fit into picture, and that solve the developer issue to have one kind of environment where you can share code with your colleagues, or share in the form of Docker file or Docker images, and you can add the volumes, and you can share your development environment to the other team. So this way a lot of efforts can be saved. And let's move on further. So why Docker plus ML? So Docker is not just for ML, it's a entire development phase tool. So it's used in entire development. So let's say this is my container. So you containerizing your code and your dependencies, whatever TensorFlow, whatever the library frameworks you need, and your code, and whatever the, maybe you are using CUDA or some kind of drivers. So there is a NVIDIA container. So you can use, if you are using NVIDIA containers in that point. So it's good to have a containerize your thing, and you can share across, you can push this into container registry. So everyone has a container registry. Like you can push on Docker Hub or other container registry. And then training cluster, maybe some of the, when you send these images to the production, or you are using in team, so you can, user can pull this particular thing and use this particular framework and train their model. So moving further, there are two what should and what should not include in ML development container model. So one is thing is ML framework and dependencies always best. That is the most of the cases when you use, you if you are scaling your workload into a lot of user, or using lot of people are using your framework, or you are hosting that framework somewhere to use extensively. So that time you can good to have, or maybe or you're deploying on Kubernetes, good to have ML framework and dependency plus your trained code on the container. So it will be easy to get things. So I'm going to show a demo on these two phases. What is the difference between both, and how you we can do, and some of the cool demos. So moving further, a little bit about Spago. Maybe you are not familiar with this library. This library, which is written in pure Go. There is no like inbuilt kind of machine learning library used. Spago itself built from the very ground. So it is purpose of this particular Spago project is starting educational project, but now people are using in production. People are using like doing a high quality implementations. So where should you use this kind of things? You can use where you need an NLP kind of system in production. You can use if you are using a interference, CPU interference, maybe you don't want to use GPU thing, but you want to achieve your task. So that is CPU interference. So you can use that. And in Go, if maybe you can, like, rather than relying on Go num or C Go, or if you are using Intel MKL or Apache Arrow, that is CPU kind of framework, you can use that also with this. And it's the simple library which give one binary, and using that one binary you can containerize it and you can run it anywhere. And another side, why this library not fit for TPU or GPU thing, because it's expensive. That's where we are using a CPU interference here in this library, and this library itself implemented based on that principle. Where like you can use, so it's why Spago is used, or you can use, because it's compatible with PyTorch model. You can take any pre-trained PyTorch model and you can use that, or you can transfer is another library. You can search on GitHub, you will get there is a 50 plus pre-trained model in 100 plus languages. You can use those pre-trained model and you can achieve with this thing. So production, it's used in production level. So I already had talked with inference. What is inference? When you use a CPU and but you want to do a extensive amount of extensive amount of training model, so that point you can use this kind of thing. So this at this point Spago doesn't support a GPU, so but it support inference. So you can load, but you need a maximum number of resources to run or infrastructure. So moving further, so some of the real time you can give, such as name entities recognition. You can say, like, you can write some kind of paragraph, and after writing that paragraph you can say from this person location or organization name, it will identify and it will tokenize it. You can use Hugging Face importer. It is one of the famous. You can search Hugging Faces, so you will get one big library where there is a lot of pre-text. Yeah, you can use multi-language. You can ask in any language. So this is some of the real-time example which I'm going to containerize it and run on a Kubernetes. Let's move further. So I'm using here a tool called Octato. Octato is a Kubernetes development platform, which how it's work. So you have a machine, you don't need a Docker installed on your machine, but you can still achieve. It's use a Octato cloud. So using a power of cloud, you can build your Docker files and you can do pretty much all the things. So now I have a namespace. So Octato give you a Kubernetes namespace for you, and Octato use some technology called Synchronize. What Synchronize will do is synchronize your source code from local to the namespace. So this way I'm going to synchronize my Docker file or Docker Compose file and run on the Kubernetes. So moving further, this is my particular Docker file. This is a Docker file. So I have a multi-stage Docker file. You can see the two form as already discussed in previous session. So here I have added a Alpine image as, and after that, whatever package I needed. So you can give that package. And after that, I have created one super user. And after that, I have created one file called docker entry.go, which contains all the, it's create, actually these commands create a binary, single binary, so I can use to run my particular container. After that, I have added this TLS. You can disable TLS also. And in multi-stage, like if you are not doing execute, or you can use from scratch also here if you want to minimize the size of this particular Docker file or Docker image. So I'm using Debian because I'm going to run this on Kubernetes, so I need a bin bash shell kind of thing to test some of the command or override my particular commands. So this is a copying from keys and whatever generated from the first stage, builder stage. So it will copy all the things, and after that it will run this entry point. And let's moving further. So I'm going to show the call Docker Compose on the Kubernetes. So Docker Compose on Kubernetes is some we call in Octato, is Octato stack, and you can take any kind of Docker Compose and copy that Docker Compose and change name by Octato stack, and you can run that. And this is a simple file. Those who not familiar, or those who coming from a Docker background and maybe they don't know YML file, what is YML file. So this is a little bit about this file, what we have here. So you can check here, I have my name of the stack. You can give any name. After that, true if it's a public image, and I have given name, you can give any name. If you are fetching this particular image from the Docker Hub, so don't give this build.context, because build.context will rebuild this thing, and after that it will run. So in this particular Spago, we have a NUR server, and we have, it's kind of a command line which have a different kind of server which talk with gRPC, and gRPC we have a protobuf thing, and protobuf is a one kind of a buffer where it's use a gRPC. And now TLS is disabled. You can give a TLS if you have the HTTPS or you are using somewhere in production, and you can give a port of a whatever the address of gRPC, you can give address, whatever address you have given here. And after that, you must resource how much resource you need for this running this all that pretend model, because we are already given model. We are using GoFlare model, which is NLP model. So you can use that. And after that, we have volume. You can give a volume as any name, and you can give a command. This is a particular command which override the entry point. So you can specify, you can specify multiple commands also. I'm going to show that. So let me show the demo now. So let me jump into code base. So this is my code base, how it's look like. So I have a CMD which is fully written in pure Go, and we have different command called bard and Hugging Face, nerd. So this is kind of a servers when I run that run particular gRPC server, and that gRPC server talks with a particular, it's fetch particular pretend model, and it's give a particular output. And this is my Docker file. So already hope I have already explained this one, and now I mean I will explain what a Docker Compose in Octato we call a Octato stack. So I have one entry point which is nerd server. So it is an NLP server which give any kind of name, organization, you can give any kind of entries or data. It take that data, it will tokenize it, and it will show, okay, this name is in this paragraph, this name is organization, this is person, and this is a location. You can, it will give that we already added a pretend model. So it's going to fetch pretend model into Kubernetes. And this is a second command, which is BERT. BERT is another framework which is used for mostly kind of question answer kind of thing. If you're not from, so you can define the resources, how much you need. You can give a port. I'm giving a different port here in for each command. So you can give, and before executing this particular program, I want to give overview what you need to do. Okay, let's say you have this file. Now what you need to do to run this thing, before the running, what you need? You need a Octato particular account. So let me open up. So this is the Octato site. You can go to octato.com. Octato give you a free one kind of a cluster to you, namespace. So you can give a start, but start for free, and you can log in with your GitHub credential. So already I have GitHub credential. So this is kind of a dashboard. You have a namespace, you can add any namespace, Spago or anything. So you can, now this is a dashboard, or you can click on deploy. You can give any kind of GitHub which contains your code, or octato.yml file, Octato manifest files, or give a branch and click deploy. It will automatically take files from GitHub and it will deploy. And you can use Helm charts also, which we have pre-built Helm chart, and it's free. It's free for particular resource. It's give a particular resource to you to run. This is my particular namespace, not a cluster. So let's shift into the code, and I will run this code now. So for running this particular file, so what I will do, I will type a command call. I hope this is visible for you. Let me do. Okay, hope this is now visible. So this is a command you need to run, which is going to build your file, and you can give call build also, and you can give a wait command. So it will show your image is building and everything. So I will give a build thing, and which is going to build your Docker file. So now it's using buildkit as a service, which is from Docker. So it's, I have not installed any Docker or anything on my machine. I have only Octato CLI, and that's enough for me. And now it's building a particular Docker file, my Docker file. This Docker file is building. So whatever changes you do here, it's going to synchronize here and send those binaries to the Octato namespace. And this way you can have a production like environment. So you can host and you can make changes faster. So it's taking a time. So I'll wait for a few seconds. Yeah, now I see. Okay, my image is pushed. And my second image is building. And you can see these outputs. Okay, second image is successfully this. And now it's deploying and it's creating a four resource for me. You can use, now Octato is compatible with any kind of Kubernetes IDE, IDE tool, or it support all the Kubernetes commands such as kubectl, get pods. So it will show the all the pods from, so I have two pods. One is Spago 0, Spago 2. So I have 2.1. You can check the state of this thing, and or you can go to a dashboard. So go to the browser and you will see here, I will hit refresh. You can hit refresh the browser, and you will see this is my thing is like particular loading, what happening logs. You can check particular container logs. So I have logs. You can see this is BERT particular copying. So you can see now this is using 7 GB. Now this is particular real-time example, real-time application using Spago. Now it's opened a gRPC server on 4.0. It means that it's running. You can get endpoints also. And this is something. which is downloading. So before that, like I want to show something, some kind of demo. Let me see if it's okay. If it's but UI. So I have this kind of UI. So you can give any kind of patches. Let's say my name is Sangam. And I will say I live in Bangalore. And you can give any kind of thing, any kind of information. And now you can ask any kind of question. What is my name? So this is all running on Kubernetes. And you can just ask question. It will, because we have already pre-trained model, so it will select the particular thing. You can give any kind of text, any kind of thing, passage here. And if you want to check currently, like if you want to see right with me, you want to test this on your side. So I'm sharing this link in chat. Let me share the link. So this is a link, you can go and you can just click this thing and you can run. So let me switch to another example, which is NLP base. And now I will open my UI. So this is all a Kubernetes base. So I can give now here any kind of thing. Let's say I will give Docker and I will give some kind of file. So I will write random names, or you can give any kind of paragraph. You can like analyze it, and it is going to currently I'm not giving. Let me give mine. So I will give some kind of paragraph and some location. Let's say Pune, let's say Bangalore. I will give 3-4 places name, or from India, and you can click on analyze. So let's see what we get. So we'll get that this is a person and this is a locations. So we have pre-trained model, and this is real time, extensively used in Italy. In the Corona time, they have Italy government did some kind of use of this kind of this library called Spago. So you can go on GitHub and you can give a star to this particular repo, or you can join my particular group Slack channel there, or Discord channel. You can connect with the creator of Spago. Matt is there in Discord channel, and this is a particular thing. So I have different particular examples, but problem with machine learning is that if you don't have a GPU, is going to take a lot of resources, a lot of memories. You need a good computation power to run this kind of trained model. Or you can, if you are training model, so, and if you are using trained model, then easy. If you are training model, you need good computation power. I see a lot of people are lacking with using Golang with machine learning, but I will see there is a lot of potential, there is a lot of tools, and those who want to learn anytime, like ping me. So this is a little bit about these two example. Hope you have understood, and you can join this Discord channel to connect with the creator of Spago or me. You use this particular link called discord.coopdaily.live, or subscribe my YouTube channel if you want to know deep into Spago, how we created. So we have done one session there. Or if you want to learn the Go language, I have gopherlab.coopdaily.com. Or you want to learn a container, any kind of container technology. So this is YouTube channel. You can subscribe and stay updated. This is a little bit. If you have any question, I'm happy to answer. If you have any question, This is used in Italy. So its purpose, actually, this is something purpose of this thing is taking a data using Cor